March 28, 1969.
This is Radio Moscow.
Only a few short weeks ago, we shared the glory of man's first sight of the world as God sees it, as a single sphere reflecting light in the darkness. As the Apollo astronauts flew over the moon's gray surface on Christmas Eve, they spoke to us of the beauty of Earth, and in that voice so clear across the lunar distance, we heard them invoke God's blessing on its goodness. In that moment of surpassing technological triumph, men turned their thoughts toward home and humanity, seeing in that far perspective that man's destiny on Earth is not divisible, telling us that however far we reach into the cosmos, our destiny lies not in the stars, but on Earth itself, in our own hands, in our own hearts.
Also, a bizarre man-made insect called the lunar module, or lamp. One day, in this 15-ton taxi, two astronauts will leave the Apollo command module in lunar orbit and descend to the moon. This is the strangest vehicle ever created on Earth, for it can't actually travel. It's the first pure spacecraft, intended to perform either in weightlessness or on the moon area, where gravity is 1/6 that of Earth. This creature has four spindly legs to stand on. Above them, a hatch gapes like an open mouth. Two triangular wings flare like evil eyes. The top is garnished by a tube, like flowers on a crimson hat. The walls of the seeker's cabin are made of aluminum, about as thick as a frying pan. Other areas are covered with heavy aluminum foil that could be kicked in by an astronaut's boot. Fragility is the price paid to make the LEM as light as possible. The main weight must go into a fuel supply weighing three times the vehicle itself and two separate rocket engines for descent and ascent. The descent engine is housed in the LEM's lower half. Its throttle gives the LEM the ability to hover so that the astronauts in a moon landing can look out a window and be sure the touchdown site is suitable. Once the LEM is landed, this lower section will be used as the launch pad and blasting off from the moon by means of the ascent engine, which is housed in the upper section. The whole thing has been compared to a badly wrapped Christmas package. It means death for McDivitt and Schweiker. The LEM, being without a heat shield, cannot return to Earth.
Thank you. Venus. I say Mars, there's no life, but Venus, there's life. I almost swear. From the way I understand, it would be too hard for anybody to live on Mars because the temperature, for one thing, is always so high. I would be curious just to contemplate on Venus. Forget Mars. Wow, look at her. Did you see that?